Hey everybody, Mike Linville here with Black Dog Education with this week's installment of Office Hours, where we answer your questions about web design, web development, and online marketing. Now this week's question comes from Dean, and Dean writes, Mike, I've been working with WordPress for quite some time, and the more I play with the site, the slower my site seems to get. What can I do to speed my site back up? A great question, actually, because page load times are important and we should be paying attention to them, right? Slow sites not only aggravate your visitors, but they're also bad for search engines because search engines take a look at page load times now as part of their search engine ranking algorithms. So, you know, when we talk about slow page load times, really what we're talking about is inefficiencies. And it can either be an inefficiency at the server level, or it can be an inefficiency at your website level. So with the server level, especially if you're on a shared hosting environment, which most people are, you know, Bluehost or GoDaddy or HostGator or one of those are a little more difficult to troubleshoot. You know, you really need to have somebody that's got a decent level of experience, it's got some programming experience. So those types of issues are usually more expensive. So we're not gonna talk about those right now. What we're really gonna talk about is we're gonna talk about page efficiencies. And the reason why we're gonna talk about page efficiencies or inefficiencies as the case may be, is because they're easy to find, they're relatively easy to fix, and they're simple to take care of without any extra tools or experiences, okay? So there are a lot of different places that your web pages or your website can become inefficient or start leaking performance. So the first top performance leak with WordPress is gonna be your plugins. Now, whenever you load a plugin, you know, and these are these fantastic little programs that help extend WordPress, right? We love them. But when you load a plugin, what ends up happening is it's not just the script itself that gets loaded. There's also template files. There are going to be images. There could be JavaScript calls and all sorts of other resources. So the more that you have of those all take away from your server and from your website page load times, okay? So if you've got plugins on your website that you're not actually using, not only do you want to deactivate them, but you want to deactivate them and delete them. The second thing we're going to talk about is we're going to talk about images. Now, when we talk about images, what we want to do is we want to make sure that they're properly sized, saved, and scaled. So when we say properly sized, what that means is we want to use images for the web that are at 72 DPI or dots per inch. Let's say, for example, you have a logo that you got from your printer. Well, printers use files that are higher resolution, 300 DPI or above. If you're using something like that, make sure that you get a saved down version, okay? Now, properly saved, we wanna make sure that we're using the proper format, right? Whether it's a GIF, whether it's a JPEG, or whether it's a PNG, those are typically gonna be your top threes. But you wanna make sure that you're saving it out properly because that can really help with your file size. And then the last thing is we wanna make sure that they're scaled properly, right? If you have a picture that's really large, if you're loaded to your website, you've gotta wait for that entire picture to load, and then it's gonna crunch down into the space that you have given it. Just load up a small image, okay? It's gonna make for a faster load time. Now the third thing that we're gonna talk about is we're gonna talk about excessive content. Anytime your website or your web page displays information that's not necessarily associated with the post or the page that you've saved in WordPress, it's gotta make a request to get that information, okay? It could be a request to your own database. So for example, if you wanted to pull like latest blog posts or show the users out of your database or something like that. Or it could be a third-party request, like if you have a Twitter feed or LinkedIn or Facebook or something like that. No matter where it's coming from, every time you make one of those requests, your server slows down a little bit. Your page load time goes up a little bit with each request, okay? But if you start getting like 10 or 15 different feeds loading into a page, let's be honest, okay? First of all, the site's gonna look bad. It's just way too much going on. Your conversion ratios are gonna be really, really low because remember, a confused mind always says no in marketing. And then the last thing is your page load times are gonna go way up, okay? That's bad for search engines and things like that. So this is what I would suggest. And Dean, I didn't take a look at your website, so I don't know if that's your situation or not. Make sure that you sit down with a professional developer and talk to them about your site and what you want it to do, and they can help you map out the flow or how your content should be laid out in a proper format. So Dean, that's all we've got for you today. I hope that has served you. Again, this is Mike Linville from Black Dog Education. I want to say thank you for hanging out. Now it's your turn. So what I want to know is go ahead and use the comments down below and let us know what's the number one thing on your site that you feel is slowing you down, okay? We'll see you next time.